Yo, what's going on, guys? KrispyFlakes here. For today's video, we have an article redrafting the first round of the 2017 NBA draft. So basically, I'm going to go through these draft picks and kind of this reorder by Griffin Lydon here. And I'm going to tell you guys if I agree or disagree with his opinions and kind of get my opinions on things too. Guys, if you enjoy this type of content, over on my second channel, Extra Crispy, link in the description below. Also on the pinned comment of this video, guys, I cover a ton of NBA content over there, like outside 2K. So guys, go check out my channel, go subscribe. I will be doing an awesome giveaway at 20K subscribers. So go check it out, man. It's a really good time or everything. It's very chill and laid back and stuff like that. But here we go. Let's get started on this and like see what it's all about here. See what type of redraft we have going on. So here we go, man, with the first pick by the Philadelphia 76ers. They got them selecting Donovan Mitchell. Original selection obviously was Markel Fultz. Yeah, I mean, Donovan Mitchell has been the best player of this draft class. So basically, you put him on the team, and that means they never really re-signed, or they never really signed JJ Redick, which is just kind of okay. I mean, JJ Redick is nice and everything, but Donovan Mitchell has been on a whole new level this rookie NBA season. They've been kind of running like Ben Simmons at point guard anyway, so all of a sudden, you're looking at a team of Ben Simmons, Donovan Mitchell, which defensively is going to be crazy. Robert Covington at the 3, Saric hit the 4, and Joel Embiid at the 5. Your team's pretty much good for the next 10 years at least. So yeah, absolutely, I would definitely pick Mitchell with that first pick. Next up, we got the Lakers taking Lonzo Ball. So I will say, a lot of people still hate on Lonzo Ball, regardless of your hate on him. He still can rebound. He's still a great playmaker. His offense is starting to come together. It just seems like the right fit, man. Like, I think of the Lakers now, I think of Lonzo Ball. Plus, they both start with L's. Probably not a great thing, but yeah. So, okay, I mean, maybe a guy like Lauri Markkanen or Jason Tatum also would have been nice, but at the same time, they got Brandon Ingram on that team, and, you know, they drafted Kyle Kuzma for the power forward position. So, yeah, I still like Lonzo Ball on the Los Angeles Lakers. All right, next up, we got to the Boston. Ooh, yo, actually, guys, this is a really nice fit. So, original selection was Jason Tatum, who I absolutely love. I feel like he's also a nice player for the Boston Celtics. But, yo, Lauri Markkanen, put him at power forward along Al Horford at center. Both those guys can shoot threes. When Gordon Hayward, assuming he would be healthy, be the small forward out there. Jaylen Brown, shooting guard, Kyrie at point guard. Yeah, that team's nice because I feel like there is going to be that awkward moment where it's just like this team has Jason Tatum and I don't think he quite fits at the power forward. I mean, you guys can, if you disagree with me on that, let me know in the comment section below. But Jason Tatum, he just feels like his natural position is a small forward. So, I don't know, man. I feel like it's going to be awkward with Gordon Hayward being back on that team. But at the same time, Jason Tatum, if he's on the bench for the next 3 NBA seasons, at that point, he's only going to be like 23 anyway. So, yeah. All right, next up we have Jason Tatum going to the Phoenix Suns. Yeah, because, Jason Tatum, Devin Booker, that right there is something you can really build around. Josh Jackson has not been absolutely fantastic. I mean, I still think Josh Jackson is going to be a good NBA player. I don't think he'll ever be great. I think Jason Tatum's ceiling is way higher. And, you know, being able to team up him with Devin Booker just seems like offensively a good move. Defensively, well, that remains to be seen. But, yeah. All right, next up, Dennis Smith Jr., Sacramento Kings. So, the Kings obviously took De'Aaron Fox as their point guard. And both players have shown certain signs that they are going to be, good NBA point guards for the foreseeable future. Whether which player is going to be better, well, I'm going to compare both those guys probably for their entire NBA career. I'm also going to compare how they played Alonzo Ball. But yeah, Dennis Smith does a lot of good things. De'Aaron Fox does some things that, better than Dennis Smith and vice versa. So a lot of stuff out there. So you know what? I mean, De'Aaron Fox, Dennis Smith, you guys let me know in the comment section below who would you rather have as your point guard. I think Dennis Smith is probably looking a bit better at this point. Next up, Kyle Kuzma to the Orlando Magic. Original selection, Jonathan Isaac. Yeah, Kuzma just kind of came out of nowhere. Like, nobody expected this from this man. Since he was drafted 27th pick. Considering he was drafted with the 27th pick, yeah. He says he's scoring about 15 points per game. You team up with Aaron Gordon, Evan Fournier, Vucevic. And, that Magic team, they might have actually made the playoffs. I mean, Jonathan Isaac just, I'm not really writing off Isaac myself here because he did have injury issues. But at this point, it looks like Kyle Kuzma would have probably been the better pick. All right, next up, we got Markel Fultz, Chicago Bulls, original selection, Lauri Markkanen. Now, I like Markkanen on the Chicago Bulls, but of course, in this redraft, he would be gone at that point. Yeah, Markel Fultz has potential to be an all-star, superstar point guard in the NBA. I know people roast him for his jump shot. A lot of that is because of his shoulder. It's like, he was not shooting like that before the shoulder injury. So, I don't know, man. I don't really understand people really hating on him for that. Ben Simmons, Joel Embiid both missed their rookie NBA season. So, it's like, right now, the Bulls, they do have Chris Dunn, who looks like he's starting to live up to that fourth pick in the draft. Maybe not quite the fourth pick or fifth pick, whatever it was. But yeah, so it's like Chris Dunn kind of could have held down the fort until Markel Fultz was ready to go out there. And then all of a sudden, you got a nice little point guard rotation. All right, next we have De'Aaron Fox to the New York Knicks. Original selection, Frank Ntilikina. Yeah, I don't know, guys. I've not really watched a lot of Kings basketball this season. I don't watch a lot of Kings out there. So, since he's not really a great shooter, but compared to Nil Aquino, I mean, I actually really like Nil Aquino's potential because I've seen him play some defense out there. Nil Aquino can actually hit a jump shot. So, I don't know. I think I would prefer to have Frank Nil Aquino, but I don't know, man. I mean, that's just because I don't really watch a lot of De'Aaron Fox. Maybe I'm just completely wrong for that, which is fine. All right, next we got Jonathan Isaac for the Dallas Mavericks. So he's like a power forward slash small forward type of player out there. I guess for a rebuilding team, I mean, no, he's never going to play Dirk Nowitzki, but, you know, for a team that has Harrison Barnes out there, I guess they would not have Dennis Smith anymore. So, no, I don't like this at all. I mean, just keep Dennis Smith for this team because he's a big part of their team, and I don't know, man. All right, next up. He says, was one of the biggest names coming in the draft due to his immense size for the three and scoring ability. Okay, well, I mean, y'all got Harrison Barnes then, so it doesn't make much sense. Josh Jackson of the Portland Trail Blazers. Man, it's Portland Trail Blazers. It seems like that team has 17 forwards on that team. Like, literally, man, they got, I believe, Alfred Kaminu's on that team, Evan Turner, a billion other guys that I can't even name because they got so many of them. They got Zach Collins, they got Myers Leonard. See, why not add freaking Josh Jackson to the mix out there? Original selection, Zach Collins, who just has not really been very good this NBA season. All right, next up, John Collins to the Charlotte Hornets. Original selection. Yeah, Malik Monk. Whatever happened to Malik Monk? He is just like, either he's just like not been playing at all or he's just been doing really bad because Malik Monk had like a big time name added to him out there. Like, people were saying this dude was going to be beasting. And so far, I don't know, man. John Collins has been a pretty good power forward for the Atlanta Hawks. I mean, as good as you can be for a Hawks player as right now, a team that's not all that great. But yeah, John Collins, I don't know. He kind of reminds me more of like an original type of power forward, or you know, like when you saw like back in the day where you know he can score under the basket and stuff like that. I don't think he's a great 3-point shooter, which isn't great, but I probably see him more as like a center in the future. Next up, Frank Nil. Ooh, yeah, I'll take Frank Nil Aquino, guys. Defensive point guard out there. It's just like that's Detroit basketball right there. I would love to have him on the Pistons. Instead, we got Luke Kennard, who I still like. Luke Kennard's shown some pretty good bright spots out there, but yeah, that would have been pretty. Good to see. Kennard has been shooting 40% from three. I like Luke Kennard personally. I think he's still going to be a pretty good player for years to come, unless the Pistons decide to trade him, which, knowing the Pistons, they probably will because they can never keep a young player around. Next up, Malik Monk of the Utah Jazz. Yeah, man, we could have Donovan Mitchell on my Pistons, man. I mean, yeah, I mean, Malik Monk, maybe a change of scenery. He would have actually went off on the team or something like that. I don't know. He just has been kind of trash. We got Bam on the Miami Heat, original selection, Bam. Okay, so it seems like the Magic, or the Miami Heat like him a lot, averaging 7 points, 5 rebounds per game, shooting 50% from the field. Looks like a good backup center. That's about what he would be at this point as a backup center. Maybe he'll be a starter in the future when Hassan Whiteside's off the team. But yeah, he's just a good backup, so can't go wrong with that. Next up, Jordan Bell, Sacramento Kings. Now, wasn't Jordan Bell selected last in the first round of the draft, I think? I don't know. He's been playing really good basketball. I know the Chicago Bulls drafted him and then traded him for cash considerations. So, yeah. Hope you all enjoy your cash considerations because Jordan Bell looked like a freaking steal on the Golden State Warriors. Next up, Luke Kennard, Minnesota Timberwolves. You know what? That actually would have been a really nice fit because then the Timberwolves could have traded Andrew Wiggins, who I still think they should probably trade in this offseason, for a power forward, Blake Griffin. And then all of a sudden, you got Reggie, or I'm sorry, I was looking at my Pistons starting lineup. I'll do that too, but no. Then all of a sudden, you got Jeff Teague, Luke Kennard can shoot the 3-4%. You got Jimmy Butler running the 3, Blake Griffin at the 4, Carmelo Anthony Towns at the 5. To me, that's a near championship team. Backcourt a little shaky because Luke Kennard would have just like been a rookie, and Jeff Teague's okay. All right, next up, we got OG Anunoby of the Milwaukee Bucks here. Original selection, DJ Wilson. DJ Wilson, your bitch ass should have stayed on the Michigan Wolverines. He was not ready to go to the NBA. Looks like an absolute bust. OG on the Toronto Raptors has been doing pretty good out there. I don't really watch a lot of Raptors basketball either. I mean, I catch him every now and then, but, you know, I don't really like watching consistently, like watch this guy, like see what he does exactly out there. Looks like he's shooting the balls consistently, which is very valued today's day. Okay, cool. I mean, he can shoot the basketball. That's good. Hopefully the Raptors actually found themselves a nice player in OG here just because, like, I don't know. It seems like the one player always missing from the Raptors is always a really good small forward. Jared Allen of the Indiana Pacers. Bro, this dude can throw the basketball down. Original selection, TJ Leaf, who could still be pretty decent. But yeah, Jared Allen, he looks definitely like he could be a starting caliber center in the NBA. Then all of a sudden, you know, got Oladipo at the shooting guard position. Probably Miles Turner, who can stretch the floor a bit at the 4 spot. And then you put Jared Allen at the 5. I like that team. Next up, Zach Collins, Atlanta Hawks. I mean, who knows what Zach Collins is going to become? He was the 11th pick in the draft. No, it says John Collins, the 19th pick. Yeah, off the board. Okay, 11th pick. Yo, when was Zach Collins actually drafted? Is this a steal or not, man? Says he's going to be a good stretch big out there, but he still has to kind of prove that. Might take a few seasons. Harry Giles, Sacramento Kings. I think, yeah, they drafted him originally. He was actually supposed to be like a top five pick in the draft, I believe, but he had like a major injury, so that's kind of why he kind of fell off a bit. In my opinion, low risk, high reward, because it's like it's the 20th pick. You don't really expect that much from that position anyway. So yeah, still like that pick for the Kings. TJ Leaf, OKC Thunder, original pick, Terrence Ferguson. He put him at the power forward position. Should learn to shoot some three balls out there, you know, play off Russell Westbrook, Paul George, Melo. Then all of a sudden, you know, you got him and Steven Adams. I think that could be a nice little 1-2 punch as far as the front court goes. All right, we're going to kind of go through the rest of these here pretty quick. Justin Patton, Brooklyn Nets. I think he plays on the Timberwolves right now. I don't really know what he does out there, but young talent, sure, why not? Jonah Bolden, Toronto Raptors. Josh Hart. Ooh, that's actually a nice fit because Josh Hart, he's actually like really loved by Laker fans. And I know the Denver Nuggets are looking for like the point guard of the future out there, so... Yeah, him alongside Jamal Murray. Who knows, man? And ZJ Passion. Philadelphia 76ers. Trust the process, hopefully, right? Trust the process. I can freaking pronounce that bitch ass name. Bro, why does this shit run so slow, man? God damn. Wow, Dylan Brooks fell down this far to the Portland Trailblazers? That would be a freaking steal, man. I would expect him to be like top 15 because he's been very nice for the Memphis Grizzlies. Yes, the Grizzlies are a horrible team. Dylan Brooks has not been a horrible player. Like, this dude is averaging, like, 10 points, like, 3 assists, 3 rebounds. I like him a lot. And he can shoot 3-ball. Justin Jackson of the Lakers. Okay. Tony Bradley, center, Utah Jazz. That's fine. Frank Mason, third of the Spurs. I mean, in that case, freaking Greg Popovich going to have him playing, like, Tony, you know, prime Tony Parker. And then we got a final one here. Man, this shit is lagging. What? How my fucking internet lagging? This ain't no PlayStation. All right, final one. We got Caleb Swanigan of the Los Angeles Lakers, guys. Okay, my friends, give me your thoughts on this in the comment section below. I thought for the most part it was pretty good. I would have had Dylan Brooks a little bit higher up, I'd say. Maybe a few changes here and there, but I think this dude did a pretty good job of this. Yeah, give me your thoughts. Like, are you happy with the player that your team drafted, or do you wish you would have got somebody else? I'm pretty much sure that, like, everybody, like, above pick number 14 or 13, whatever it was, wishes they would have got Donovan Mitchell. I know I do as a Pistons fan. But anyway, guys, thank you all so much for watching. Be sure to check out my channel, Extra Crispy. Peace out, my friends.